What we need is deep men and women of God, prophets who are saying what he's saying, who live in secret with him, and who walk about the earth as if they've come from a different world. Every generation, there has to be a select few that will lay down their lives for the sake of the brethren, that will lay hold of God and stir themselves up. And in a culture, and even in a Christian culture, that where the watermark of passion and devotion is so low, it is so easy to feel like we are already stirred up, like we are already going for it. But the plumb line isn't the culture, the plumb line is the scripture, and it's the person of Jesus. He looks for an intercessor. And all throughout history, he has used intercessors. And I'm saying today, why not us? So an intercessor is somebody that puts their life on the line. An intercessor is a Moses who's willing to take the burden of 3 million people and lead them. An intercessor is a Daniel. An intercessor is a Joseph who had the wisdom to save the nation from famine. An intercessor is a Jesus who would hang upon a cross between heaven and earth, saving humanity. That is what an intercessor is. The world needs us to live a different life. For you to release awakening, you must first be awakened. The life of an intercessor we see from Scripture is not the easiest one. But it's the way of glory.